Hello everyone, welcome back. I'm Murdo Todd. I'm delighted to be joined by Kurt Hollibaugh, who fights March 23rd. How's things, mate?
Doing good, man. Got a good notice for this. So, been training for the fight ever since I got the phone call, and I'm doing good.
So you'll be taking on Trey Ogden, fairly experienced, good amount of submissions for on his record. Talk to me a little bit about what you think of him as an opponent.
I mean, he's a solid opponent. He's got a pretty well-rounded game. Good jiu-jitsu guy, and hopefully that'll make for a good fight for the fans.
Do you kind of expect to finish in this one?
I think I'm always going in trying to expect to finish. I feel like I got the capability of finishing, anybody I fight. So, as long as I show up, do the things that I think I need to do, I feel like I can, I could definitely look for a submission or knock out and ultimately get the finish in the fight.
This will be your first fight after winning Tough Season 31. How do you kind of look back at that whole experience now?
It was a great experience. It was something that I didn't know if I wanted to do at first, when I first got the phone call. But now that it's all said and done, and seeing what I've been able to accomplish and get out of it, it's been a great part of my career to do that show. And I don't regret it for a second. I think it was the best thing I've ever done.
Obviously, the second time in the UFC. Have you noticed any differences? Is it whether it be with fans or how things are run since the first time you were here?
I don't think it'll be any different. I think just now I'm just more experienced, and I feel like for me it's like I've already been there, I've already done that. I've been in the UFC. It's like not a big deal. I'm here with a different mindset that I'm not comfortable at just being in the UFC. I'm here. I want to be able to, chase rankings, and ultimately, I want to be a champion. And I feel like I do have the skill that I can do that.
You win this next fight, you've got yourself on a really good run, some good finishes. What do you kind of envision next? How fast do you think you'll move?
You never know, but I think winning the Ultimate Fighter is a big accomplishment. I think that still sets me a little higher than most guys on the UFC roster. So, with that, you never know what I'm going to get. You never know what the UFC is going to throw. I feel like this is a really good fight to get me started on. I need to go out there, and first and foremost, I need to get the job done against Trey Ogden. But after that, you never know, man. I would like to jump up, and I'd like to start fighting these guys either right outside the top 15, or hopefully get a ranked guy. Even after this fight, I was calling out Patty, which is makes sense. He's not really a ranked guy, but I think that's definitely a guy to spring me up into the rankings. But there's a number of guys that I called out. Some of them are ranked, some of them are right on the outside. So we'll see what happens. But first and foremost, I got Trey Ogden in my way, and that's the guy that I have my sights on right now. And none of that matters if I can't get past him.
Are you able to kind of enjoy things a little more now, since you're back in the UFC?
For sure. I feel like even before I got back at the UFC, sometimes you forget why you fight. You forget you fight because it was fun. That's what made me start fighting at the beginning years ago. And sometimes we might seem to lose that a little bit or forget why we fight. When it's not fun anymore, why would you want to fight? So I feel like I really got back to that. I've got back to why I love fighting. And I've been doing that for the last couple of years, even before I made it back to the UFC. And it's all about the fun for me now. And now that I've, kind of made a name for myself, sitting getting on that platform of the Ultimate Fighter and winning the Ultimate Fighter, is even that much better. So, I feel like I got a name. I feel like I'm pretty well known by most UFC fans now, and that's fun to me.
Have you got a kind of bucket list this time around, anywhere you'd like to fight? Any particular things you'd like to do before, you eventually kind of call it a day?
Well, not I wouldn't really call it a bucket list. I've always wanted to fight in Japan. If I never do, I won't sweat it. But I don't even know if the UFC is going to Japan or ever will. But if they do, I would like to do that. Other than that, man, I like to be home in the United States. It doesn't really matter where. I would like to go to adventure or venture out to some cool states that I haven't been to before. But, you know, I've fought in a lot of places. I fought outside the country. I fought in Brazil. I fought in Russia. So if I was going to fight outside the United States, I would definitely like it to be Japan. But other than that, you know, I'll stay in the United States and anywhere out here.
You know, we're kind of in an age where a lot of fighters are going to these kind of mega gyms, whether it be, you know, ATT or wherever else. You know, you remain with what would be considered a small gym. Why have you chosen to do that, and why is that kind of important to you to kind of stick with your roots?
I don't know. Well, one of the main reasons is because, you know, I'm a family man. I have my wife. We have five kids together. You know, I own my two gyms. So sometimes it's hard for me to get up and just leave. Yeah, I have my wife that runs things. I have some of my instructors that help out with all the classes. But it's not like when I'm here. I like to be here. But I get around a little bit. You know, I go to Mobile, Alabama, and I train with a coach of mine called Jimmy Mills, or his name's Jimmy Mills in Port City MMA. So I train over there. I'll go to my Brazilian Jiu-Jitsu head coach, who is basically the founder of our gym name. He's about 40 minutes from me. I'll train with him, you know, most time throughout the day, get my Jiu-Jitsu training in. And then I'll probably get out to Kill Cliff. I think I got I already got a plane ticket booked for mid-February. I'm going to go out to Kill Cliff, spend a week or two out there, you know, reunite with my tough coaches like Coach Stroud, Sean Soriano, get some work out there. But it's still nothing like being at home, man. It's nothing like sleeping in your own bed, which I understand, you know, a lot of people have to make sacrifices. But, you know, I got good guys in my gym, too. I feel like I get good push. You know, I still feel I've been successful in my mixed martial arts career, training out of my little small gym that is constantly growing, though. You know, I got some Bellator fighters, got some PFL fighters, got some good regional fighters that, you know, could be getting a shot at the UFC here soon. So that's my overall goal, is to build more UFC caliber fighters to train with.
Brilliant. And you mentioned your family there. I know your wife, very successful at jiu-jitsu, and your kids are taking up martial arts. What's that been like, that whole experience, kind of passing on your knowledge? I'm sure you're absolutely buzzing with that.
No, it's awesome. It's almost like I get to do it all again, you know, through them, watching them grow up and watching them, you know, compete mixed martial arts. You know, even when my wife, she goes to Vegas, she competes for the IBJJF World Championships. You know, that's a fun time for me. And I've done it too. Me and her, we both done it last year. And it's just a fun time, you know, and you know, we get to go out to Vegas, hang out, you know, do jiu-jitsu competitions. Last July, we took our kids out. They competed in Vegas, so that was fun for them. And it's just, I enjoy seeing them grow as martial artists, and I feel like I can relive fighting through them also. So it's fun.
Fantastic. You know, I'm curious. A lot of fighters, like when it comes to fight time, they maybe want their family away from things. But you know, you had your kids at the weigh-ins. Why do you choose to have your kids so involved? I know some fighters are kind of, they're not so comfortable with it.
I don't know. I think that's just the way I am. You know, I want my kids to experience everything I experience, if that makes sense, you know. And yeah, getting to bring my kids on stage for a UFC weigh-in. How many kids can say, hey, I went on stage with my dad for UFC weigh-ins, such a big event, shake Dana White's hand, you know. Now my kids get to go back to school and tell all their friends, yeah, I was on the UFC stage this week when I met Dana White and walked out with my dad. So, I mean, that's just cool for me, man. That's the reason why I fight. And I feel like that's fun for me to be able to go out and fight and give my kids that kind of stage to say they've done all these things.
Fantastic. You know, still early on in the year. What can we expect from you in 2024?
You know, hopefully to keep doing what I've been doing for the last year. You know, I kind of took a year off of fighting, not really by choice, just not really being able to find an organization or a fight. And then I got called by the Ultimate Fighter, and, you know, I fought three times last year. So I would like to at least fight three times this year. Hopefully I can keep a good win streak going. Got a tough opponent in front of me right now in Trey Ogden. So one fight at a time, but you know, who knows? Maybe I can get three fights in this year again.
Brilliant. Well, thank you very much for your time. I really do appreciate it. Best of luck with everything.
Yeah, I appreciate it. Thanks for having me on.
Make sure to subscribe to the Low Kick MMA YouTube channel for all the latest news, event previews, and interviews with some of the biggest stars in MMA.